வணக்கம், நீங்கள் இணைந்திருப்பது வீரகேசரி இணையதளத்துடன்.
Our partner are the Shanghai Cooperation Organization. This I consider as an important achievement in terms of Sri Lanka's wide international engagement and multilateral focus. I will now give you an account of the Shanghai Cooperation Organization. The 9th meeting of the Heads of State Council of the Shanghai Cooperation Organization, SCO, met in Yekaterinburg, Russia, on 15th and 16th June and decided to grant dialogue partner status to Sri Lanka. The Shanghai Cooperation Organization, which is known as SCO, is a permanent intergovernmental organization established in 2001 in Shanghai, comprising 6 countries: China, Kazakhstan, Kyrgyzstan, Russia, Tajikistan, and Uzbekistan. The main goals of Shanghai Cooperation are strengthening mutual confidence and good neighborly relations among the member countries, promoting effective cooperation in politics, trade and economy, science and technology, culture as well as education, energy, transportation, tourism, environmental protection and other fields, making joint efforts to maintain and ensure peace, security and stability in the region, moving towards the establishment of a new democratic, just and rational political and economic international order. Recognizing and subscribing to the main goals, principles and actions of the SCO, Sri Lanka expressed its desire to become a dialogue partner. Thus, at the 8th SCO summit held in Dushanbe, Tajikistan in August 2008, I as the foreign minister wrote to my counterparts in the 6 member countries seeking their support to become the dialogue partner of the organization. In this context, we received the support of all member states. In particular, I wish to place on my record, my sincere gratitude to the foreign ministers of China and Russia, whose invaluable advice and guidance was extremely helpful in securing this dialogue partnership status for Sri Lanka. In the light of the successful eradication of the menace of terrorism from the country, Sri Lanka's membership in this forum as a dialogue partner would enable it to share its experience of countering terrorism with the membership. In para 14 of the final declaration, of the head of state of SCO concluded yesterday, the member states welcome the end of the internal military conflict in Sri Lanka and express their hope for establishing a firm peace, strengthening security and stability in Sri Lanka on the basis of ensuring its state sovereignty and territorial integrity, guaranteeing the rights of all ethnic and religious groups.
மேலதிகமான செய்திகளை உடனுக்குடன் தெரிந்து கொள்ள வீரகேசரி இணையதளத்துடன் இணைந்திருங்கள். வணக்கம்.